Iffah is a scientific officer with the Lee Kong Chian Natural History Museum. She specializes in the study of jellyfish.
We are at the wet collection. So there are two kinds of collection space in the museum, the dry collection and the wet collection. Wet because all the animals here are in preservative. It's either in ethanol or formalin. My jellyfish is in formalin.
The museum is home to over 550,000 archived specimens. These rare specimens are mainly for scientific studies. Iffah first worked with specimens when she was studying zoology at the National University of Singapore.
My first encounter with specimens and preserving specimens was in the Comprehensive Marine Biodiversity Survey, trying to understand the marine biodiversity around Singapore.
The survey ignited Iffah's passion for specimens.
Every time I get a specimen, a jellyfish specimen, what I'll do actually is that first I would have to identify it, and then after that I would make sure that they are preserved properly. So a jellyfish usually has to be preserved in formalin because the formalin helps to retain the structure of the jellyfish. The jellyfish collection actually also has historical specimens, and these jellyfish have not actually been identified. So what I do is I go through the collection and identify or maybe even re-identify some jellyfish based on updated literature. It is important that the integrity is preserved for future generations to come, because eventually, hopefully, someone would come along and identify them, and then it's still in the perfect condition to be worth something for science. So there are many different ways to preserve the same animal. For example, you can mount them in a more realistic way in a taxidermized specimen, or you can flatten them out, and they could still be very useful scientifically, but for different reasons, people would process them differently. Over the years, you realize how much historical materials there are and how important it is for every generation of curator to make sure that every specimen's integrity is preserved over time.
The Lee Kong Chian National History Museum has a collection of specimens from the colonial era. Some are over 150 years old. From routine maintenance to archival work, everything is painstakingly done. The person who once looked after this priceless collection is 77-year-old Mrs. Yang Chang Man. Mrs. Yang's vocal cords were affected when she had to undergo chemotherapy in 2018. Mrs. Yang had a strong interest in biology when she was in secondary school. But her grandmother disapproved. Fortunately, she had the full support of her uncle, brother, and mother.
那么这是我进南大的时候参加一些课外采集标本的照片。这是基隆，在基隆上面，我们一批同学就利用参考书，把这些遗分类找出他们的学名。对鱼类有兴趣，后来我就进到新大都鱼类文凭班，我们常常要检查
After graduating, she worked as an assistant at the Regional Marine Biological Center, pursuing her interest in marine biology. She got her Master of Science in 1972. In the same year, she was appointed curator of the Department of Zoology at the University of Singapore. Singapore's National Museum used to house wildlife specimens collected from all over Southeast Asia. In 1972, the museum took a new direction, and parts of the specimen collection, kept solely for research purposes, were handed over to the Department of Zoology at the University of Singapore. Mrs. Young was tasked to oversee this collection. The specimens in it contained genetic information that would help the study of species evolution.
全部是一个抽整个抽屉都是标本。当天看了之后，我是很兴奋。这些标本很多都是在19世纪就从东南亚采集来的，现在还这么完整。However,
Mrs. Young never dreamt that she'd have to move some 130,000 specimens four times over the next 16 years. The first temporary home was five Romney huts in Ayer Rajah. She was also given a budget of only $750 for the move. Mrs. Young and her team gave it their all. The relocation took an entire year. The next thing they had to do was to restore the specimens. The specimens were then moved to the Bukit Timah campus. The sheer size of the collection took up the staff quarters, the law faculty, and the basement of the old arts block. But it wasn't long before Nanyang University and the University of Singapore would merge. The collection had to move again. But this time, there was no suitable place to house it. Mrs. Young feared that the specimens would not be able to withstand yet another move. Any damage to them would affect their scientific value. The administration's evaluation of the collection also left her feeling helpless and angry.
They saw a piece of paper. 回去报告,
密室是收藏了很多棺材，棺材里面都是死的标本。他们把它全部形成是没有用的东西，形容那些是棺材哈，对我来讲哈是一种好像有点侮辱的意思，对不对？
那些是宝来的，他说是棺材，没有用。A suggestion was made to split up the collection, but she insisted on keeping it together.
戏里面也没有人怎么站出来说这个收藏品是很重要的，我是孤军作战，我就想到说。
Compared to Mrs. Yang, Iffah's path has been smooth, with guidance from her seniors and mentors. In 2015, the carcass of a sperm whale was discovered off the coast of Jurong Island. A team from the Lee Kong Chiang Museum was sent to prepare it as a specimen. Iffah was involved in the operation.
The salvage of the Singapore sperm whale was my very first official project after I graduated. I felt that was very inspiring because not just one person, one team can do it. It was a really a national collaboration in a way to allow us to do what we do.
It took Iffah and her team 70 days to clean the sperm whale's skeleton.
We realized that every single intervertebral disc fits very specifically to each of the bone. So if you mismatch them, they will not fit. So labeling everything was so important to us. It was very challenging because there are actually a lot of techniques to employ. And so I actually had a lot of help from my colleagues who have had experience like this.
Back in the 80s, Mrs. Yang also needed help to protect the specimen collection under her charge.
后来一个自然学会的秘书写了一篇报道，Save Our heritage. 这一篇报纸出来了之后，接触下来就有相当多的反应，说，这样好的收藏品，假如失去了，这将是永远遗失。Foreign
museums also wrote in to express their interest in taking over the most comprehensive zoological collection in Southeast Asia.
美国的自然博物馆的馆长写信给新加坡政府，后来我又拿到他的这个稿，写给李光耀的一封信，告诉他这个收藏品的价值。Eventually,
things took a turn for the better. In 1987, NUS assigned three floors of its science library building to house the collection. After 16 years of turmoil, the specimens finally had a proper home. And then in 2015, they were moved to the Lee Kong Chian Natural History Museum.
讲到这些事情，有时候我很激动，我要坚持下去，不能够半途而废。Besides
the specimens themselves, the collection records at the Lee Kong Chian Museum are also important historical documents.
These data sheets were from a really, really old project. And when I asked around, no one really knew anything about it. And when I looked through the paperwork, I realized there's one particular person, Mrs. Yang, who worked on it, and she was the main researcher. So if I were to meet her, I would definitely ask her about this.
Mrs. Yang Chang Man retired in 2004, but stayed on at the Lee Kong Chian Natural History Museum as an honorary research associate. She continued her research work till 2017.
Hi, Mrs. Yang. Hi. It's so nice to meet you.
Yes.
My name is Iffah. So I found this of yours. Do you remember?
Oh,
Yes.
Today, she's back at the museum to meet Iffah.
When I look through every single data log that was so detailed and the number of medusae, which are jellyfish that I was so interested in, I was really excited. I was like wondering, where are these?
I think you should go to the plankton section.
Plankton section.
We have freshwater plankton,
uh-huh.
And then the other one is marine plankton. I think freshwater one is kept separately.
That's amazing.
They are very small.
Yeah. What are the challenges that you face on the expedition? Like, were you the only female in the team?
Yeah, sometimes yeah. I'm the only female, sometimes not.
In the 90s, Mrs. Young took risks going to undeveloped areas just to collect specimens.
Mrs. Young, 我看你走得很辛苦，你就在这边等啦。我说，哎呀，不要啊，等下老虎出来我怎么办？我自己一个，所以挺辛苦，跟着他们进去。
I can't imagine facing the challenges that she did at that time. It must have been a lot more difficult, a lot more DIY. And I think that kind of resilience in itself is very inspiring. So, Mrs. Young, I heard that you also studied your master's while working. Was it very tough for you?
Yeah, it was tough. I collect the samples weekly, every week.
Wow.
Nighttime collecting, then next day bring back and study.
After meeting Mrs. Young, I realized that there is a potential for me to take for granted what we have today. Like, there was this one portion where she had to remind me that at that time, there was no museum. So I was
very lucky. I had like a bunch of people. I saw Iffah, a very young researcher, very passionate about his research, very curious, very happy to have someone in this field.
This is my very first drawing that was published. It's very, very difficult for me because I wasn't sure how to properly transfer details from the actual 3D form into a 2D form. My favorite expedition is my very first one, which was to Christmas Island. I think that was also very eye-opening. Yeah, so I think different habitats and different expeditions teach me so many different things.
Mrs. Young is also taking the opportunity to catch up with old colleagues. They've been encouraged and inspired by her to go into scientific research.
Mrs. Young is very passionate. She very supports us. We catch any strange thing, bring it home, put it in the museum. She also very appreciates our help.
他们还记得我的兴趣，所以改天我会回来继续做这方面的研究。I'll say that what one can learn from Mrs. Young is that her perseverance and her scientific integrity. She realized there was a gap in scientific knowledge for insects, so she decided to put herself and challenge herself to work on aquatic insects.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
She had been very ill during her fight with cancer.
经历的这个治疗过程是很辛苦的，我甚至有一度想要放弃生命，因为我受不了。
Then in 2018, she found out that she had been inducted into the Singapore Women's Hall of Fame. It was to honour the efforts she'd put into preserving what is today called the Zoological Reference Collection.
我最喜欢的植物是这棵艺术。风吹的时候，树叶就会慢慢飘下来，你会觉得心情很好。我们人生常常会碰到很多困境，但是当有机会的时候，尽量争取坚持，不要放弃，最后是会成功的。
Every story of every specimen is unique. Each have their own story to how they came about to belong in the gallery or belong to the museum.
The poppy is my favorite flower as it is associated with symbols of belief, remembrance, and eternal rest.